Stabat Mater looks like an amulet, like prayer. But it isn't really. What it is that it's a soul thinking about the scene of the crucifixion, contemplating what does this all mean? Why is it happening? And to some degree, as you know, salvation sometimes is very capitalistic. What is in it for me? How does it relate to my salvation? And so, one of the key ways of knowing God and getting to know Him is through beauty. And if we learn anything from Pope Emeritus Benedict, if you wanted to summarize his life in one sentence, it would be that if that remains, we can know God, so choose. And one of the chief ways of knowing God is through beauty. Maybe the most fascinating and most attractive way to know God is through beauty. And the chief art of all arts is church music, because it combines sacred melody with sacred word and makes a unity that brings the presence of God to our hearts immediately and instantly. Even the most hardened hearts can realize and can get to know God through beauty. Pergolesi wrote this as his last piece of his life. He died very young, age 26. This was his last work. And so the way he organized it is that the first six movements are a new story. It states the facts. Stabat Mater Dolorosa, at the cross, her station keeping, stood the mournful mother weeping, close to her son, to the last. And so we have this news report coming up of the crucifixion scene, the next six stanzas. And so it starts with the most mournful and beautiful, humble violence and starts soaring with more and more dissonance. Dissonances that don't even resolve, symbolizing that Mary is there watching in pain as her son is dying. And with these sharp dissonances, they often don't even resolve for four or five or six bars that keeps getting stretched and stretched until almost the breaking point. And in the middle of this movement, you all of a sudden hear the choir soar very high, and the dissonance is becoming very sharp. And that is a symbol of a forecast of what is to come, because the biblical prophecy is that Mary is the one whose soul will be pierced by a sword. And what we get here in the first movement is an emotional forecasting of it, as the choir really soars in very high, sharp dissonances. That is the moment where the sword is piercing her soul. And so we start with movement one, Stabat Mater. Thank you. is about, the second movement is now about what I've been forecasting in the first. The text is through her soul of joy beneath, bound with anguish deeply grieved, now the piercing sword at last. And you can hear this in the orchestra, very aggressively stabbing. Also reflected by our marines.
Thank you.
has always been a puzzle to me. The words are extremely traumatic and dramatic, who mourned and grieved and trembled looking at her child with torment inflicted. And yet, the music is almost like a birthday party. Suffering and irony. And it is a puzzle. For years I thought, what was Pergolesi thinking of this? And then, just in time for our concert, it struck me. This is mocking, right? And mocking is part of the passion. The devil lurks from everywhere and takes delight in the suffering of Mary and takes delight in the suffering of Jesus. And so this is what this is. This is the mocking, one of the big parts. Hey, come on down from the cross. Bring a legion of 1,000 angels. If you are the Messiah, why don't you come down? It is that mocking what is symbolized. And we have poor Sammy here doing a very good job being the devil. But I may assure you that these are really, really, really nice times.
Thank you.
distinctly having a capella motet by Maestro in Victoria. Very famous setting, almost on this, three times he is clairvoyant. And we're grabbing up that theme that we were just were. Who would not cry? Who would not see? And the text here means all you who pass by, stop and see. If you have witnessed any sorrow like mine, all the nations stay and look upon my sorrow. Jesus is demanding, come, see, contribute. It's a demand. And so very panicky. And then as soon as it talks, talks about Jesus, absolute serenity, absolute surrender, absolute calmness and agreement of what has happened. It's the most wonderful change, and that change happens twice.
Thank you.
result of having seen Jesus die, as we just did, what is the result thereof? What is the effect thereof? Well, make my heart to glow within me, loving God who came to win me, breathing love in every wound. We are realizing now, we're starting to commit to Jesus, having seen what he has done for us. We are now ready to commit with burning heart and with strength and vigor. And so this is probably the loudest and most rambunctious movement in the entire Stabat Mater, the movement in Fatsu Alia and Make for me. So number 7.
Thank you.
As you've heard, they're committed now. And so, Book 9 is now a contemplation of this commitment. It's a duet, very tender, very beautiful, very soaring. Make my heart glow within me. So this is not personal. So we've made our commitment. And now we're wondering, again, of what does it do to me? Make my heart glow within me, loving God who came within me, reading love in every womb. That was the commitment. And now the Holy Mother pierce me through in my heart, each wound renew, deep as in your own lady. And this is the most beautiful setting. Sometimes. it stands out in this movement because of the love for the sun. Beautiful soaring violin lines. We do have again those jagged rhythms because we are talking about things that we deal with these wounds inebriated by the cross. But as you can hear again, the cross is the solution. work in, the best is saved for last. As my, when a stone my dust shall cover, grant my soul your saving offer, paradise is glory place. Amen. May I recall a few things for you, that Pergolesi wrote this as his last work. He died of tuberculosis, and it's a long death. You know it's coming. So when Pergolesi writes about Paradisi Gloria, the glory paradise, there is a really personal meaning to this. And we now slowly start realizing that that soul that is floating above the scene making all this commentary is Pergolesi's soul himself. He is sitting at his desk contemplating his own death as it's coming. And so, is Pergolesi afraid? No. Is he worried? No. He is peaceful. He is peaceful in the most meaningful and beautiful way. When you hear that note, whenever the word Paradisi comes up, the texture changes, the volume changes, the most beautiful, solemn, peaceful notes floating above the orchestra what it's doing. The most powerful description of peace that is really possible in my opinion. And let us also think, who are the messengers of this? Our children. And there, I think, are the best to tell us about Paradisi Gloria. Why is it? Because children sing with integrity, by definition. You cannot force a child to sing. If you promise them 10 tons of gummy bears, they'll go mad. If you were to put them at gunpoint, they would freeze. You know, when children sing or make sounds, it is always with honesty and integrity. Because, for example, think of children running through garden sprinkler in the summer. The delightful giggle that you hear, that has integrity. And integrity is linked to truth, and truth is what we are being told by the choir about the Paradisi Gloria. And may I recall again the words of Pergolesi, that it is through beauty that we can learn to know God. And so I invite you at this very, very moment, right here, right now, as you're melting in your pews from those beautiful violins, from those beautiful sounds as they're coming, that you be transformed right here, right now, that you know there is a God, that you know He loves you, and that you know where you will end up soon.
Thank you. basically a beautiful round by William Burke. It's a very clever round. Non nobis domine, non nobis. Not unto us, O Lord, but unto you be glory given. And it is a round, a canon, like C blind, you know that. But it is a three-round canon that starts from different pitches. So the same melody, but in different entry points. Non nobis domine by William Burke.
Thank you.
and show them to the assembled group. Olivia, you no longer need them. I have your new folder with your new practice card already in. And here, Olivia, please receive your blessing.
Benedicta tua in mulieribus, Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Dii lauda Dominum.
Dear Olivia, it is my great pleasure to crown you a senior of the Ottawa Sparrows choir school.
Please receive your blessing. Dominus vobiscum.
Thank you very much, everybody, and I hope you had a fun week.